North America are the fattest people who have ever walked the face of the planet. And there is growing fear that the generations now living, lounging, and growing even more obese are doomed to die in epidemic numbers from type 2 diabetes that often leads to heart disease and stroke. Now, you can get depressed, you can feel disheartened, you can even choose to deny the disease, or...
I'm as mad as hell, and I'm not gonna take this anymore!
You can get good and mad and not take it any longer. And Dave Sitton, well, he has every right to be mad.
It's a vicious, dirty, filthy disease which deserves our scorn.
You see, Dave's grandpa died from diabetes, and his dad?
Well, he was a 6'4" Texan, died of the complications of diabetes when he was 78 years old, minus two legs.
As the disease becomes more prevalent, so do amputations. In fact, every 30 seconds, there is a diabetes-related amputation. Just since we started this video, four people have lost a limb. Diabetes causes circulatory problems that, at its worst, restricts blood flow to the legs. A tiny cut can fester.
Gangrene will set in, and at that point, you have to start cutting the feet off. And this is a grim reality of diabetes, so I'm not going to sugarcoat this at all. I want everybody to understand this is how it works. And time again, you'll hear about diabetics. They leave the planet without their legs.
The Orio Community Health Center is pushing back hard against this devastating disease. We are arming our patients, our community, and a whole new generation with the tools they need to take back control of their bodies. They may not be ready for Dancing with the Stars, but stars they are, the kind that point the way to health and fitness and a life free of diabetes, heart disease, and stroke.
Buenos dias.
Josefina and Salvador are part of the El Rio Diabetes Prevention Program. A promotora is a community outreach worker responsible for raising awareness of health issues. Josefina knows all about diabetes and how it can rob you.
I was blind. I was 3 months blind. I couldn't see. But I didn't know I was diabetic.
El Rio doctors diagnosed her. She now eats and shops healthy. She exercises every day and has her own diabetes in check. She and Salvador say education and support is the best weapon in combating diabetes. So they are spreading the word. The El Rio Diabetes Prevention Pilot Program was launched through funding from Pfizer. The program has targeted the Hispanic community because Hispanics are twice as likely to fall victims to diabetes than non-Hispanics. Frances knew something was wrong. She was always so thirsty, and she felt so very, very tired. Those are just two of the typical symptoms of diabetes. But it was when the exhaustion caused her to lose an entire day that she finally got help.
Algunas veces me quedé dormida en el bus, dando vueltas y vueltas toditito el día. Salí desde las 9 de la mañana y no recalé a mi casa hasta las 8 de la noche.
Dormida.
Those involved with the El Rio Diabetes Prevention Program are lucky. Frances says she was diagnosed in time to save her life. There are almost 6 million Americans who don't even know they have the disease and that their bodies are time bombs. Louis Castro was a very loved and respected member of our own El Rio Foundation, a big, strong, full-of-life man in his early 50s. Louis would have probably been here tonight raising money for the El Rio Diabetes Prevention Program. But 2 years ago, Louis Castro died of complications from diabetes, a disease he didn't even know he had.
He was so closely knit to this program, but never did he even think that it could happen to him.
It was just over a week between the time Louis was diagnosed and his death.
He survived 8 days after he was admitted from the hospital, and when we thought he was out of the woods, he went home. And the day that he went home, 4 hours later, he had a pulmonary blood clot, and that's what took his life. But the blood clot came from the dehydration caused from the all coming back to the diabetes. Diabetes will shut every organ down in your body.
Steve Nunez, Louis's best friend, says he would have moved heaven and earth to save his friend had he only known.
And it's never easy to go through a death, a loved one. But Louis, and it just didn't hit me, because you're used to saying this is a disease that impacts and affects older people, not young guys, you know, not guys middle-aged or, you know, having a good time and strong and vibrant.
In a large prevention study of people at high risk for diabetes, lifestyle intervention like getting more exercise, losing weight, and eating right reduced the development of diabetes for all ages by 58% over 3 years.
It runs in my family. Diabetes runs in my family, and I just never recognized the symptoms to recognize that, you know, my best friend was suffering from diabetes.
And knowing saves lives. It saved Francis. It could have saved Louis.
It snuck up on Louis faster than we could blink, faster than we could say, hey, it is diabetes.
Don't let diabetes sneak up on you or someone you love. The El Rio Diabetes Prevention Program works. So come on, raise the pepper, because we're all in this together.